Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this series of videos termed as Tech Bytes. In this series, we are discussing the vocabularies of Bebop version 3, and the topic for this video is user story. As the world has now moved into the agile software development process, the focus has shifted from writing too much detail to simple and short but concise documentation. User story is one of those powerful tools which is used for this purpose. My name is Dhaval Sankhla. I am an IIBA certified business analyst with more than 11 years of experience in the software industry. I am part of Techcanvass, which is an IIBA endorsed education provider and ISQI authorized training center. We offer a range of training and certification courses, some of which are business analysis certification courses, automation testing courses, and domain training programs. To begin this video presentation, first of all, let's look at the major points we are going to cover today. We'll begin with understanding what is a user story, and then we will touch upon what are the key points to write a good user story. Post this, we are going to cover step-by-step process of how a user story is developed. And then finally, we will take an example to create some user stories. Now, user story is a short statement which contains the functionality required by the stakeholder. In other words, I can say it captures the need of a user role and also the value they are going to get out of it. It is at a high level and contains the minimum details which are required to define a need and the benefit achieved. There are various structure present for developing a user story, and there is no mandatory structure, and companies do alter them as per what fits them, but the most widely used format is this one. If you see in this sentence, there are three key words, which are who, what, and why. The who represents a user role, or also termed as persona. What represents the desired outcome, or it represents the expectation. And finally, the word why, it signifies the benefit or the value achieved. We will take an example to understand this particular statement better. Now, this example says, as a customer, I need to have an option to save my card details so that I need not feed it repeatedly. So you can see that the customer is the user role here. He is expecting to have an option to save his card details. So this is what is his desired outcome. And what is the benefit he is going to achieve? He need not feed the information again. So this is the benefit achieved. So this is how a user story can be written in this format. There are always certain guidelines for any sort of documentation. Similarly, there are certain rules for writing a good user story. The first is, it should be written in active voice. I'll give you an example to differentiate how a story is written in active voice and how it is written in passive voice. So let's take an example. As an online buyer, I want invoice on my email. This is something which is written in active voice. The same thing, if I convert it into passive voice, it will be like, the invoice should be sent on the email ID of the online buyer. This type of sentence formation in passive voice is not appropriate for user story. Rather than using the generic word user, we should use user roles to give more context to the this user story. It should contain just sufficient information, not too detailed, like if you include UI design features in it, it shouldn't be there. Also, it shouldn't be too small that it is not clear enough. So as I said, it should not be too detailed and it should not be too small. It should be close-ended, which means it should not leave the reader with doubts. Rather, it should include the precise information. Now, in this slide, I have tried to cover the steps required to create a good user story. Now, since everything revolves around the user, it's first essential to identify the user roles and then the goals and target which are we are going to achieve out of it. Once these are identified, we can identify the epics, which are nothing but the high level statements about the required functionality. After this, we can try to create user story, wherein we try to include all this information in small but comprehensive statements. Now, let's take an example now to try and create user story. UT Limited is a new exchange to be launched in the market. Now, apart from doing the regular business of selling and buying currencies, they also plan to provide the service of bank transfer of funds. For example, customer can pay US dollars in cash at the counter and the exchange will transfer the money to maybe say his bank account in Malaysia. Now, below are some of the needs for which we will try to create user story later. The first need is a fees of USD 5 should be charged per transaction. This fees could be deducted from the transfer amount, or if the customer wants, he can pay it separately on top of the transfer amount. An SMS and email alert should be sent to the customer mobile once the money is successfully transferred. And the last one is customer signature to be taken as a confirmation for fund transfer. Now we will try to create user stories for these particular needs. Now, as I said earlier, for user story, everything starts with a user role. So we basically have two roles here. First is the cashier, or we can also say the exchange operator. For our ease, we will use the cashier. And the second role is customer. After we have identified the roles, let's note down what we are trying to achieve here. So these are the goals we are trying to achieve. First one is a transaction fees of USD 5 should be charged per transaction. Fees to be deducted from the transfer amount or can be paid separately. SMS and email alert to be sent to the customer. And customer signature to be taken as fund transfer approval. Now we have the roles, we have the goals. Let's try to map these two together. Now if you see here, first goal, USD 5 should be charged per transaction. This particular goal can be mapped with cashier. I mean, the customer won't say that please charge USD 5 from my account. It will be the cashier who is going to charge. So we can say that the first goal is for the cashier. Similarly, we'll see this second goal. It should be for the customer because he wants an option to pay this fee separately, or he can say that, okay, please include this from my transfer amount. Again, this SMS and email alert will help the customer. So this is a requirement from the customer. And finally, this requirement, which is customer signature to be taken as fund transfer approval, is from the cashier because he needs to make sure that the customer signs before he makes a fund transfer request. So far, we have got our goals and roles mapping, which means we have managed to get the information of what is needed by which user role. Now let's create epics for these roles. Now, as we said earlier, epics are nothing but high level statement. So we can say this epic is transaction fees applied. Both of these goals are related to the transaction fees. So we can make one epic as transaction fees to be applied. For this one, we can make as customer alerts to be sent. And for this one, we can say the epic will be customer confirmation to be taken before transfer. So this is how we have designed the epics for these goals of the different roles. Now this slide is very crucial, since here we will try and identify the key elements which will assist us in our story building. Let's try and recollect the most common story format, which is this one which we have seen earlier. We have our roles, we have the goals. Now we will try to identify these parameters here. Who wants this particular, or this need is from which role? So it's the cashier, here is the customer. Again, this is a need from the customer and the cashier. So we have managed to identify the who part. Now we will try to identify what they expect out of it. What is their expectation? It is the goal which we are trying to achieve here. So the goals are basically what is needed by the user role. And finally, the part why. So if I see here, the cashier wants to apply a $5 fees per transaction, and what he is going to achieve out of it? He is going to generate the revenue for the company. Similarly, we have seen here the customer wants to have an option to pay fees separately or deduct from the transfer amount. What is he is going to achieve out of it? He is going to have a flexibility of fee payment. And here the customer wants to get the SMS and email alert. What could be the reason why he wants it? To track the fund transfer. And here cashier wants to get the customer signature. For what reason? To get the customer approval before he make a fund transfer request. So we have managed to identify all the key parameters which are required to design a good user story. We have now collected all the necessary information we needed. So let's now connect all this information together to create our user stories. Again, I have put our story format so that it's easy for us to design our story. We have the who part, we have got the what, and we also have the why part. Now let's connect this together and see how the user story will look like. So if I read the story, it will be, as a cashier, I want to apply $5 fees per transaction so that the company earns revenue. This will be our user story. For the second need, as a customer, I want to have option to pay fees separately or to be deducted from the transfer amount so that there is a payment flexibility. For this need, as a customer, I want to get SMS and email alert so that I can track my fund transfer. And the last one, as a cashier, I want to take customer signature so that I can get customer approval for fund transfer. So you see, this is how we create user stories. And there is one more point that I'd like to mention here, is that optionally you can also mention acceptance criteria with these stories, which basically serves the purpose of testing these stories to make sure that they provide the desired value when implemented. Now that's all we have for this short video. Do refer to our website for more details on the various courses and trainings. Thank you.